Alright, so it's the start of video for day 471, making Songbringer. And this is like part 4 or something of making procedural audio. It's not procedural rhythms, it's just procedural melodies. You just came from the best sushi meal you ever had while... Right here, this is the procedural music right here, Arcane, so... it's only going to be level 1 for this first update. I had every intention to get to making the overworld music procedural too, but there's just like not enough time in 1 week. Day 420, that was a good one. That was a great one. So yeah, the game procedurally chooses, you can see it shows the notes right here. It's got note 1, 2, 3, and 4. So it chose C, A sharp, A, and G. It chooses notes based on a key. The musical key is chosen based on the world seed and the dungeon. So each dungeon will have its own musical key. There's a few limitations to Fmod, the engine I'm using, which I think are going to be solved in the next version of Fmod that they're coming out with. So I'm going to just do the best I can for now. I had planned so every single room you would go into, it would change the notes, but because of those limitations in Fmod, I'm kind of just going to wait on those and then consider changing all the notes again once those are fixed. So there are some things I want to do today to finish this up and kind of just make this, to wrap up all this procedural stuff for now and get an update ready for Steam. So yeah, this is the exact same tune as it was before. It's just that now it's procedural. So basically, this is kind of what it looks like. I go and I create the track in Ableton. And then in Ableton, I have this script now where I can take each track in Ableton and export it 12 times. So for just like the base zero track, for example, there's 12 different tracks all exported. They can all be different. They can all have like subtle differences if necessary. But then anyways, it procedurally selects which one of these tracks to play based on the note one value. And then I can pretty much do it. You know, I can use that those note one, note two, note three, note four. I can use those however I want for all the rest of the tracks. So yeah, it kind of is. It's difficult. And it's time consuming too, because each one of these tracks has to be exported 12 times. And you have to kind of like make sure that the music is going to sound good in all of those different notes. And there's a big difference between A and G sharp. It's like there's a lot of a difference. There's almost an entire octave worth of difference between those two notes. So mixing and mastering is also another challenge. You got to like, you got to make sure that your mix and your master is still going to sound good no matter what you throw at it. All these different notes. All these different possibilities for all these different tracks. So, but anyways, I think this is sounding pretty good so far. There's a couple things I want to do to this track that I think can make it sound a little bit better. The first one is that when it first starts playing, it's got the bass zero at full volume. I want the bass zero to fade in. So let's hear it one more time. It's kind of neat, but I do want that to fade in anyways. So I'm going to create another track. Pedro, what's up? You got free parking. I've won the free parking like twice this week. I got like, and lots of points too. Bafu is very generous with me this week. All right, so track bass zero. I think what's going to happen is that I want to duplicate this track. What happens with this index? Okay, that goes down based on that index. Okay, let's add another audio track. so rich. Okay, so this is going to be base 0, index 0. Yeah, Fmod Studio is, it's all right. It has all the features that you would need, but it's lacking in a little bit. Little things like, I wish you could just press Control A to select all the tracks. That doesn't work. And you can't copy and paste a bunch of tracks at once. Like if I copied all these tracks and wanted to paste them, you would expect that it would just paste all these tracks right here. But it pastes them all on top of each other. So there's a few little things where it's like, I wish it just had some of these standard little features that make a program nice and easy to use, but alas. All right, so I'm gonna make it so base zero plays if the index is one or above, and then base zero I zero plays below that. And then base I zero has its volume automated. So it looks something like this. We'll have a really nice fade in. Let's try a negative 12. Aesthetically, it looks like it was made in MS Paint. There's that too. Yeah, it's doesn't have a strong aesthetic. But I will, you know what? There's some pretty badass features though of Fmod. You can actually you can connect to your game live and then get profiling information. So you can actually profile your audio. And it's awesome. It's super detailed. It gives you all like how much CPU usage you're using, like how many voices each instrument's using. It's like really, really good detailed information. So the engine behind Fmod is really good. It's just this Fmod Studio that's kind of needs to evolve a little bit, you know? Just get a little more user-friendly. Can even come in a little quieter. Let's try negative 18. And okay, let's try this out in the game. I think it's pretty good. A little fade in. Good. That was really, really nice. I want this first track to sound just a little quieter than the rest of them. So, another part of the procedural part of it. So this is really more adaptive. It's not really that procedural. Well, I guess it is procedural. Anyways, this is the index parameter. As I go from different room to different room, it changes the index parameter. It brings in drums. As you kill more enemies, it gets rid of the drums. So it's kind of an indicator of how many enemies are left in the room, how many drums are playing. And so eventually all the dungeons in Songbringer will work like this. It's gonna take quite a while though to convert all these musical tracks. But anyway, so that's index one where it starts playing the little chirpy noises that are these? C and A sharp. sure these are all lined up. Base zero has a looping region. Base one has a looping region and a tempo marker. Yeah, looks like I did this all right. Chirpy, same thing. Okay, that's good. Close this. Okay, good. Now we got the bass fading in. I want to now, the next thing I want to do is to apply some some randomization to the drums. So each one of these kicks, hats, and snare hits, all of these can have a little bit of delay. Time-based delay. Okay, here's where I kind of need to see Ableton. I need to know exactly how long the delays are that I typically use for my drums. Like what I'll do is I'll, you add a little humanization to audio by shifting things around. Like for example, your kick shouldn't really fall on exactly, you know, exactly the one. If it falls exactly on the one, it sounds like a drum machine. It sounds like a computer is playing the audio. But a human, when a human plays with audio, they're never perfectly on time. And that's what sounds so beautiful about humans playing instruments, is that it's got that sort of slightly offbeat feeling, almost jazzy. So that's about something like I would typically use maybe about like this to this, like that much delay for humanization. So what is that? How much time is that? .03. I think that's about 15 milliseconds. And if this was all the way to there, it'd be 0.05. Is that right? Am I reading that right? Minutes, seconds. I think that's milliseconds. 54 milliseconds. Yeah. Hold on. See if I can confirm this. Nah, I don't know. I'm pretty sure that's milliseconds. 0.054 sounds about right anyways. 54, right? It's 54 milliseconds. So we're talking anywhere between 30. Right, 1,000 divided by 54. Okay, so If our drums, each one of these elements here has a delay interval between, say, like 20 to 50. Can't change it. That's another little thing about FMod Studio, man. It's the little things that make it, like, so difficult to work with. You can't set this value. Oh, wait, you can. You just gotta double-click on that part. Oh, okay. That's a little better. 20 to 50. There we go. All right, so the other thing I wanted to do, so there's two things I want to do here. Is like, one is I want to make the kick, snare, and hat procedural. And that's going to require throwing every single one of these kick elements into its own contained thing here. It's like, do I really want to do that right now? Yes, I do. Okay, let's do this. Kick noise. Start with the kick noise. Pretty simple. All I want to do is take this. Oh my god, I'm so nervous to open up. Adobe Audition, it crashed the stream last time. Okay, I guess I can export this. What I want to do is make sure that this sound that I export right now is the same volume as the one I'd already exported, because I really played around with this track since then. So, okay, I'll do B first. I'm gonna do B, C, and C sharp. If I have three different notes, that's enough to make it procedural. So I'll always have the kick track, snare track, and hat track, always using this one note. So I'll have like a note 5 or a drum note or whatever, which is always going to take the musical key and find the note closest to C, which is either going to be C, C sharp, or B. Every single key has one of those. I say that, but let me just confirm that. Yeah, the distance between any step in any key is always at max 2, so there's got to be a B, C, or C sharp in every key. This one has both those. This one has a C. This one has 2 of those. This one has 2. This one has 2. This one has 2. Yep. 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 Okay. Confirmed. All right. So I'm exporting a C sharp. Gonna be mono. This is a kick long. This is in our FMod assets. Cool. Kick long 0 C sharp. All right. Now make sure they're the same volume. Okay, so they're definitely smaller. I don't want that. I want them to all to be big when they're exported. So let's do that again. This time, use volume zero for this kick track. That's still small. Either that or it didn't update the waveform. They both sound almost exactly the same volume to me, but that's hard to tell. Just 3 dB. Let's check this out. Come on, baby. Come on. I might have to chance it and open up Audition. Or I guess I could create a new project in Ableton. Ah, I guess I'll do that. Okay, let's go back to the drums. Oh, nice. They're fine. It was just the waveform. Okay, cool. They're exactly the same now. Yay! Okay, so I've got a C sharp. Let's do a B. And now we need to do the short kicks, making sure they're at the full velocity too. Oh, they're like all full velocity now. Like, whoa. So this one is a kick short, zero, B, and we do kick short, zero, C sharp. And it's pretty important to have these be exactly the same length. Let's confirm that. Just makes it way easier to work with. In Fmod, Fmod has this one little issue where, okay, yeah, they're exactly the same. If you change a file size, Fmod just doesn't like it. It doesn't recognize the difference, which it can really screw things up. Okay, so let's put that back to how it was. This track's how it was. Now that's back to -3. Cool, we've got six different little kicks. Blip, blip, blip. And short kicks. There's very little difference between those sounds, but I think this will make a difference in how the procedural songs fit together. Because right now I'm always using a C, which they might not be in key. In fact, I doubt it's in the, I don't know what the probability is, but. All right, let's do the same thing for hats and snares. Snare, Got that at negative 9. Did I do that here? Yeah, this is negative 9. So I think I gotta export these as 0 as well. Set u to 0. And probably just that much. So Ableton is excellent at stretching audio. It's freaking awesome. So what I do here is I'm gonna warp this sound. Oops. Why did you do that? Why did you change the length? I have to warp this sound, but I don't want it to change that beautiful sound. Okay, it's not. It's just adding some silence to the end. Okay, so that's how it's going to start. Oh, we want to use complex. This is a... Every single one of these has its own algorithm, which makes things sound different. Complex is probably one of the best ones. It almost sounds exactly like the sound is originally made or whatever. So, okay, so this is a sample. I can't just change it like I did my kick. I have to change it by transposing it and warping it, which, like I said, Ableton has a kick-ass transpose. So basically, I'm going to go up one to make a C sharp. I'm just going to export it as it is like that. This is snare. 0, C sharp, or snare long. I guess this is a long, snare long, 0, C sharp. I want to make sure they're exactly the same size. No, that's 21. Okay, well, it doesn't matter. I can re-export the 0, C. Being a little longer. Oh, but that's really gonna mess up this whole project. Unless I fix it. I guess I'll just have to fix this whole project. It's fine. It's a pretty fast fix, actually. Okay, let's put that back to 0. Sal dongs, ahoy! Avast! What's going on today, man? What you working on? It's going to be a C. Replace. And now they should be exactly the same size. 21K each. Cool. And then this one, we're going to go down one to make a B. Voice of Grog, what's up? What up, man? School stuff today? What kind of school stuff? What classes are you taking right now? This one, you can actually tell the difference between these sounds. Okay, so back to Fmod. We're going to import the snare and then fix the other snare. Fix the existing snare. So there, we got C sharp right there. I'm going to delete that. Actually, let's delete that first. Let's close Fmod Studio. Okay, so here's the trick. I have to go fix all the lengths of these sounds. Mate, F, raw, Fmod, metadata. All right, I want to search for snare 0C. No, is that not it? Oh, snare long. Snare long 0C. Okay, and this is going to have the, wait. There. The C sharp is going to have the correct length. But the C is going to have the wrong length. Okay, so everywhere that I see this value, I don't really need to change it in the event, actually. Let's just change the sound file. So C sharp has the correct length. Let's just paste that over on C. There we go. Okay, that's it. And we get back into fmod. Okay, and I did export that all with zero. Should be exactly the same volume. Oh, it's returning this back to its former state. Okay, now the last one is to export the hat three times. Take a couple programming classes. And gen ed. Oh, yeah. What do they have you learning in programming class right now? Okay, so for the hat, we're going to warp this. So 0.02 warp. Good. Okay, that looks fine. Put this on complex. Put this at zero. Solo it. An Excel project? Really? I won again! I won the free parking! So great. Thanks, Bapu. Nothing exciting. I spent all of yesterday, this is kind of another nothing exciting thing. I spent all of yesterday installing virtual machines. I have like a Windows 7 32-bit, Windows 7 64-bit, Windows 8 32-bit, Windows 8 64-bit. I have so many virtual machines now, but I did confirm that Songbringer can run without any need for Visual C++ redist files. VMware is the tits, man. I like Fusion. That is some rad software. I previously have been using VirtualBox, which is the free software from Oracle for doing virtual machines, which was okay, but it didn't have OpenGL support for version 2.0, so I couldn't run any games or anything. But freaking VMware is badass. It has OpenGL 3 support, and it runs almost as fast as rebooting into that partition would. So I guess that is kind of exciting. One's an algorithm design class. Oh, Babby's first C course. The other is for Babby's first Java course. Man, I've been there. I've taken some of those classes myself. All right, so we got it. Little synth rim. All right, I'll start with transposing upward. This is going to be hat 0C sharp. Now I want to make sure they're exactly the same size, or else Oh, hat zero C is way long. It's kind of weird. I don't know if I ever exported that. All right, let's save this as a C. You have to take introductory courses before they'll let me get to the interesting stuff. What? I know, man. Can't you challenge them? Can't you just challenge those classes? You're like, dude, I don't need Babby's first C course. I'm a C badass. See for yourself. Lol. At B, C, C sharp. All right, cool. Now, since we have three different notes for every one of these drum things, we have everything we need to make procedural drums in key, any key, all 12 keys, with only three notes each. So beautiful. Guaranteed. Okay, so let's put this back to its former state. It's -9. That's unsoloed. You could be warped, but you should be not transposed. All right. That's good. Now we can close live. Thanks, live. See you live. Later. Once again, I gotta close FMod Studio and change all these hat events. Hat 0C. Oh, dang it. I need, testing out is probably a possibility. Oh, you'd rather have the buffer? It is nice though, right? It is nice to have those easy classes to start with. Smooth and easy. Let's see a hat, C sharp. And we can delete it, close this. Search this. C sharp's the right length. C is the wrong length. Close. Reopen. Next summer or fall gets interesting. Right on. Okay, so we've got all the elements. We've got everything we need now. The next thing I'm going to do is, so every single one of these kicks and snares and hats needs to become its own separate event so that I can change it procedurally. Ooh, courses in game dev, computer graphics, operating systems, image processing, hopefully neural networks, other radness. You're gonna be like programming your own AI, your own robot AI. Like, check it out. Your robot will see too. You're like, check it out, my robot can see things. It can recognize cats. Okay, what's up? What's up? What's up? We need to kick. Start with the kicks. All right, we'll start with the kicks. Come on. All right, so we need to create an event sound. Kick. All right, we're going to base all this on a parameter called, we'll add one called, so we got note 1, 2, 3, 4. This one is going to be the drum note. It's 0 to 11 is, no, it's only 0 to 2. 0, 1, or 2, which is B. B, C, or C sharp. I guess I could make this 0 to 11. A cat-seeking robot, yes. A robot that tries to pet cats, that's all it does. If it sees a cat, tries to pet it. If it doesn't see a cat, it doesn't do anything. It just sits there waiting for cats. It would be a marvel of modern day creation. Should I make this 0 to 11? Yeah, let's just make it 0. I don't want to confuse the rest of these notes. All right. 0 to 11, drum note. Which means I need to pass it down here. The drums get drum note. 0 to 11. And then the kick event will have drum note. You would buy that robot? What's up, Chocolate Beer? How's it going, man? How you been? Drum note. We also want to pass down intensity, probably. Nah, intensity can just be here. This is where it chooses what its intensity and all that. And it can play with volume. So yeah, all it needs to pass down is drum note. Okay, so inside the kick event, we're going to have three different audio tracks. You'll hack it so it has to pet me. Sounds like a good use of your time. Why not? All right, so we're going to have kick long. Oh, we need two different, we need several different events. We need a kick. This is going to be kick long. Does not repeat. This is kick long B. Kick long C. And kick long C sharp. Oh my god, I just realized something awesome. I can make, since it's a sub event now, I can have one single time delay. I don't have to set a bunch of freaking time delays for a billion different kick separate events. Let's go 10 to 50 there. Yay for not having to set things a million times. You've no girlfriend at the moment, man. Oh, the times we live in. Right? Yeah, you definitely gotta get on that, man. You need a robot. You need a robot that you can program. All you need to learn is like neural networks, convolutional networks, boom. Your robot can recognize you versus a cat. And then, yeah, dude, the petting part is easy. That's the easy part. Motion, dang, simple. But recognizing you, that's the tricky part. That's where you gotta get all connect and stuff. Connect, or whatever. All right, so we got three kicks. B, C, C sharp. Oh, these are triggered. Oh, what? Oh, I put these in the wrong place. Damn it all. Come You can't cut. That's another thing I don't like about Fmod so far. You can't cut things. You can copy or delete, but you can't cut. So if I go like this and I want to copy these, it's going to throw them all on top of each. Oh, it didn't throw them on top of each other. It just did them next to each other, which isn't as bad. Okay, I can live with that. All right, let's get rid of those. This is supposed to be here on the regular timeline. Oh, it did. Oh, it reversed their order. So weird. You're bigger and a bit less hairy than your cat. That would be a good starting point. Right? It should be pretty easy for the robot. You're doing everything you can for this robot, man. The robot should be thanking you. What's up, Mr. Francie? You never heard about Fmod Studio? Well, it's not really a traditional DAW. Like, it's not really a digital audio workstation like Ableton or Logic or whatever else you want to work in. This is more for games, and that's why it's kind of limited and stuff. The cool part about it is it has all these things called parameters. So this is pretty neat, Mr. Francie. So, like, I can create this whole event called Level 1, for example. And my Level 1 event has an index parameter, an intensity parameter, note 1, note 2, note 3, note 4, drum note, all these different parameters. So when I'm in the game, right, you can pass different parameters in, you can set different parameters, so your music changes. Your music changes as you play the game. Like, for example, I can go change the different notes that are playing and make procedural audio. Check it out, when I go into this room, there's enemies, the drums kick in. And as I start to fight enemies and stuff, and I kill a few, the drums go away. And then, once I kill them all, the drums are totally gone. So that's what I'm working on right now. I'm actually dialing it in, so this little procedural track you're hearing right now has different notes for the kicks, snares, and hats. So the kicks, snares, and hats will actually be all in the musical key that's been decided at runtime, based on the world seed and the dungeon number that you're in. So these drums will sound just a tad bit better. All right, so once again, we're back to this kick long event. Each one of these things has a slight delay, a slight random delay, which is pretty neat. It's gonna make it sound more human, a lot less like a machine. And the next thing we need to do is add the drum note. So the drum note, oh, that would just be a trigger condition right here. Thanks, Salad Dongs. Yeah, the percussion kicking in is really neat, isn't it? Yeah, I've tried to do my mixing and mastering live this Thursday or whatever, and I can't do mixing and mastering live because Ableton, like, just totally died on me. It was... Because game show was using up so much CPU percentage, Ableton couldn't produce audio that was clear anymore. It was like crackly and had all this static noise. So I couldn't actually mix and master. I was like, damn it. So I had to kind of take a day off from streaming that day. But yeah, so since you last heard it on like Wednesday or whatever, the tracks have really evolved a little bit, at least in their mastering. Okay, so kick long 0B, it'll play this if the drum note is A, A sharp, or B, which is 0, 1, or 2, which means we want 0 through 2.5 for this first drum note parameter. And then kick long 0C is going to be 2.6. through 3.5. Let me just think about that again and just double check. There's A sharp, B. Wait, so A would be 0, A sharp would be 1, B would be 2, C would be 3. Yeah, okay. And then this last one is 3.6 all the way up. Okay, I do believe we've got the kick event created correctly, the kick long event. Now we need a kick short and a hat and a snare. Okay, so instead of kick long 0C, we'll use kick long event. We should still hear this. Okay, cool. We've got that working. Now we need to create something that's going to mirror. It's going to be for this here. So create another event sound. Let's call this kick short. Use the drum note parameter. This is 0 to 11. All right. Three tracks. All right, so we want the kick short. Make sure I'm on the timeline this time. Kick short 0B, C, and C sharp. Zoom this in. All right, each one of these is going to have a little bit of delay. And a parameter whether it triggers. It's 2.5, is that right? Yeah. To 3.5. Yes, Mr. Francis, you can add effects like reverb. Totally, yeah, you can do that. Keep in mind though that FMOD, every one of those effects that you're going to be using to do that is going to incur some CPU cost to your game. So I'm trying to avoid using effects as much as possible. I'm trying to basically move most of my effects into where I actually create the music in Ableton. So I'll create my tracks and I'll add my own reverb and stuff like that for the most part in Ableton. And then here, I'll only use like effects if I really need to. But yeah, there's some good effects and not really. What do you got here? Yeah, there's like your standard 3 EQ, channel mixing, chorus, compressor, convolution reverb. That's cool. Distortion, delay, flanger, high passes, limiters, low passes, parametric EQ, pitch shifting, regular reverb, transceiver, I don't know what that is. Tremolo, there's also 3D panning, which is pretty neat. Yeah, for the most part, I try to already bake things if necessary. So yeah, it's got some pretty good effects. And then you can also profile your audio, which is really sweet. You can profile your audio to make sure that your audio is not eating up too much CPU. So that's a pretty neat feature of FMOD. Audio acceleration stopped being popular. Oh, that's right. I forgot all about that stuff. Wow. Good point. I wonder why that is. Probably because not as much importance has ever been placed on game audio. It seems more important to people to do their graphics really good. Because motherboards start including stuff. Oh, okay. 3.6, yeah, okay. Just making sure I had these right. 2.5, 2.6, 3.6. Think this is good to go. All right, cool. We got two more events to create. So the kick short, we want to make these way shorter. Whoa, whoa. Like that. All right, so let's get rid of that one. Here's our kick short. And let's proceed to create a hat or a, no, a snare. When NVIDIA releases the ray traced binaural audio, is that really a thing? That sounds like a real thing. That's awesome. Snare, okay, yeah, snare. Oh, I do want to make sure the intensity parameter is correct before I go duplicating all this. So this is going to be intensity 0.66. To 1.0. And then the same thing for this kick long. Right? Yeah. 0.66 to 1.0. All right, cool. There. Glad I did that. Yeah. Seems like we're doing a lot more and more things on GPUs these days. Which is neat. The GPU is kind of like a specialized CPU that's really meant for things that are, you know, high concurrency. Snare. All right, we're gonna create a snare event. I believe the snare goes from intensity 0.34 or 33. Yeah, 0.33. Okay. Now, snare event also has the drum note parameter. Let's drag in our snares. Yeah. Yeah, right? They are, huh? I know. With CPUs becoming more parallelized, I'm like, damn it, now I gotta worry about how many branches, how many ifs I'm putting in. Snare, snare, snare. Snare B. Snare C and C sharp. Okay, triggers via the drum note 3.6. And as a little bit of delay, random delay. Oh, the latency. Oh, very good point about latency. How big is the latency on a GPU? Ah, that's an excellent point, Ragathian. And what's up, by the way, man? Latency. What could it probably be? A millisecond, 2 milliseconds, 3 milliseconds? Or am I way off? Is it more like 5 milliseconds to 15 milliseconds? 1 millisecond to 5 milliseconds wouldn't be too bad for audio, but it would start to become noticeable at 15, I would say. actually, if you're a pretty good, if you're an audiophile, you could even feel like 3 milliseconds of a difference. It's just so ever so slightly different, but still. Like if you're a sound engineer or an audiophile. This is going to be 2.6 to 3.5. Look at me throwing out numbers like I know what's up. Barely even know what's down. 10 to 15, yeah. 10 to 15 milliseconds for data to go to a GPU and come back. You're probably totally right, because that's about how big your frame rate is, right? 60 frames a second is, I think, 15 milliseconds? Yeah, no, yeah, 60 frames a second is 16.6 milliseconds. So, yeah, I mean, if you're rendering... I mean, GPUs can go faster than that, but like an average GPU running at 60 frames a second could only process every 15 milliseconds or something like that. What's up, Dreadsteed? Oh yeah, 33.3 would be 30 frames a second, right? 1 divided by 30. Yeah, that's about, yeah. That's 30 frames a second, which is also, you know, some GPUs are only going to be able to do 30 frames a second, depending on how complex the game is, of course, or whatever. Yeah. Yeah, that's a really good point. It's a really great point. Because 15 milliseconds is way too long in audio sense, at least to people that know, that can feel that, you know, like, I can definitely tell the difference between 15 milliseconds. That's 15 milliseconds creates like a delay effect. Like you can hear an echo almost. It sounds really weird if you're going to be hearing that. And it will really mess with your feeling. Like the feeling of the game will really, really change if it's off by that much. You know, it's not really something that's mostly, it's not really that conscious, but it's subconscious, you know, it's like, it's noticeable on a subconscious level. Oh, right, data up and down, you're right. Uh-huh. So we got snare long, B0 to 25, C 2.6, 3.5, 3.6 to 11. We got delay. Okay, these are all set up. All right, we've got a procedural kick long, kick short, and a snare so far. The last one here is the hat. And I believe the hats are full intensity. Yeah, or it doesn't matter what the intensity. We got the end. Man, Bob Food's just throwing it out. Thanks, Bob Food. Create one more event sound. All right, so this is going to be the nested or the hat event. Once again, we have a drum note parameter. This is going to be, you know, basically we only need three different notes to be able to create procedural drums. They're just slightly different tuned. Tunings. All right, we got snare. We already did those hats. Hat B. Hat C and hat C sharp. All right, now we had parameters. This is the first note, and it's a little bit of delay. 2.6, 3.5. Last one. Yes, it's about time. 2.6. Wait, 3, is that 3.5? Yeah, 3.6. Do things so much that you don't even... What is that? Why does doing something over and over and over fatigue your brain? Should be easy, right? What's up, Zanger? Howdy, man. Okay, well, now we've got the hat ready, the snare, and the kick. All of these are now sub-events. Oh, the hat does need a trigger condition, but it's really nothing to it. It's just the same intensity all the way across. All right, so now I can override all the snare events, kick events, and hat events. Okay. Let's do this. That's where the hats were. The sucky thing about doing these like container events or whatever is you can't tell what each one is. Look at this. I'm zoomed in pretty far and I can't tell that that's a snare and that's a hat, except that I guess it, keep it in this organized tracks or whatever. Let's just make sure that we're okay so far. Okay, cool. Why is the hat so quiet? The hat's like really quiet. Did I export these all wrong? Let's hear it. No, those are fine. Those are totally fine. What could be doing this? Is it some like an intensity automation? No. Huh. Okay, so it sounds fine when I'm using the regular hat events, but when I use these ones, they don't sound good. Why? Right, yeah, what I'm wondering the same thing. What could be putting the volume low? I mean, well, where there's this, but that's supposed to be -9. I mean, what if I just put that back to 0? It's almost like the drum note's 0. Yeah. We should be playing hat 0B because we're drum note 0. Got a volume of 0. That should be fine. All these have volumes of 0. Oh yeah, just hearing it right here, it sounds way too quiet. Why? What if I make it really loud? Okay, there, if I make it really loud, it sounds about right. What if I put a little delay in here? Nothing? What the hell? Is maybe it's this delay interval. I've never worked with this yet, so maybe it's just messing things up because it has the delay. Let's see what happens there. Oh my god, that was it! Oh, that's bullshit. I can't believe that. It's another bug in Fmod. So this delay interval is acting exactly like start offset's supposed to. Start offset's supposed to shift the beginning of your sound. Right? So if you set your start offset at 10%, it will start playing 10% through the sample. But delay interval is doing the same thing, which is super lame. That sounds fine. What if I have my drum note at like 3 or 2? Or 3. Yeah, see that? It's random, but sometimes it sounds totally wrong. What if I set the bottom to 0? Maybe that will somehow affect it and make it work. Damn it, you can't have random delay. Nope, see, that time it didn't work. That time neither. Nope. Yeah, shit. That sucks. Well, at least it's not a huge thing to go fix at this point. Which it would have been had I done this to every single instance of the event. Oh my god. Well, another bug to report to Fmod. Alright. Oh, damn it. I was hoping that would be cool. I wonder if I could do it on the outside. Like to the containing event. Let's fix all these so none of them are using delay anymore. Nice. It sounds exactly like those. Perfect. Okay, so wait. What if I add some delay on right here? To the containing event. Will that work? Let's find out. Find out next time on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? That was weird. It's got some weird issue where it just plays the sound. It's doing the offset another time. Maybe it was. I think that's a bug in Fmod Studio where it plays that initial sound right away. But I think this is working. It's actually delaying the event here if I do it to this outside, which is pretty cool. So let's do it to all these events before I go and copy them a million times. 50 might be a little much, actually. I wish it didn't have that little bug where it was like stuttering at the very beginning, because hearing the first part is pretty important. the weird stutter at the beginning. Wait, oh, you know, I should throw this in the game before I just assume that that stutter is Fmod's fault and not, or I mean Fmod Studio's fault and not in the game. Let's make sure that that works. That was really weird. It played the first few hat noises. It's not supposed to play. Oh, there, it did it again. Oh, I think the hats are supposed to be point. Oh, yeah, okay, no problem. This is supposed to be 0.1. So if the intensity is 0, the drums are all the way off. Okay, that's an easy fix. Easy fix now before I go and duplicate this a bajillion times. Let's rebuild that. I'm glad I'm testing this before doing it. Once the pattern's in place, it just will take forever to go and edit again. Okay, good. We have no more hats playing at the beginning of this effect. Gotta fix that. Yeah, it does. It does sound right. Okay, so I'm confident in this, in the drum pattern. All I gotta do now is fix this, or go change all these other events, all that, to these. And that's pretty good. That sounds pretty good with the with the random delay, doesn't sound too much, and it didn't have that weird stutter, which whatever the heck is going on here in Fmod Studio. So now it's just going and placing these throughout the pattern. Here's a kick long. Here's a kick long. What the? If you don't have the track selected when you press paste, it doesn't work. There's so many little oddities about working with Fmod Studio. It's, oh man. It's good to laugh about it, I guess. Oh god, it's so weird. Okay, there. We got all the kick longs converted. Let's do the kick shorts. Okay, we got four of them here. Somehow pasting these littler notes works fine. Just pasting those other notes just didn't work. I don't know why. And we haven't even passed it the drum note parameter. The drum note parameter will push the drum notes to either a B or a C sharp instead of a C, depending on the musical key the game has chosen. So that should make the drum sound a little bit more in tune, which is going to be a nice little touch. Nice little touch. Nice touch, man. Oops. Anyways, you ever heard a producer say, tune your drums? It's important. It's important, kids. Kids watching this, tune your drums. You got that? It's muy importante. There we go. All right, we got all the kicks converted. Just one little make sure. Whoa, oh my God, dude. Oh, sorry if anybody. Jesus, did you guys hear that? That was not my fault. That was FMod. Lord, dude. Oh, God, man, that was horrible. I did not mean to hurt anybody's ears there. Freaking little FMod bug. Your producer? Sorry, guys. Sorry. Oh, man. It hurt me just as much as it hurt you. Or maybe more. I had my volume up pretty loud. Sorry. Sorry. Sorry again. Jesus Christ. All right. Well, now let's just not even play things here in FMod ever again. It's just going to throw all of the latest sounds that it's like it's had in its audio queue. Just throw them all in at once and play them all for you. Here. Listen to all these sounds at once, man. Isn't it beautiful? Getting there. This isn't too bad. Now that everything's all set up. Okay. Last thing to do is convert these hats. I wonder if it could do four at a time. That would be neat. This is right on the one here. Oh, it can. That's cool. Here we got four. Not on the one. And then a fifth. And then all these together, four. Okay, then one got one more here. And then the last little bit is an eight. Eight of them all together. All together now. One, two, three. Hey, thanks for following. I appreciate it. So we got one. These are all on the something. We'll just delete all those. last one. Yes. Yes. All right, cool. There. I'm not going to play this in Fmod due to that last little incident. Okay, I'm just going to build it and hear it in the game. Oh, yeah. We'll hear it in the game. Then I'll send the drum note parameter. We'll play with that. So it'll shift the drums just a tiny bit, depending on the musical key. It's weird, some weird issue where it doesn't play the bass all the way through. What is that? What the heck is going on there? But the drums are sounding all right. Seconds is a little bit too much sometimes. Especially when it's doing those last rolls. Like, it sounds alright when you hear it once, but if you hear it four times in a row and one of them is like way off, it's kind of annoying. Let's turn these down to 30 then, or maybe less, maybe 25. Maybe 0 to 25. Thing with the hats. Okay, I really gotta fix the hats now too. Damn it, I should have trusted my instinct and not done 50. 0 to 25 is a lot more reasonable. Especially for these sections here. maybe even 0 to 20. Alright, let's do that again. Transitions to going into the room. Sometimes it starts to like it plays half a kick, which is that fmod issue that I was talking about at the very beginning of the stream, but hopefully they'll fix it in 1.09. Snares need it too. Maybe not as much though. God, yeah. Chuck a bear. I'll give you the consolation prize. You're welcome. Did you hear that? I said you're welcome. As if it were natural for me to say that. You did. You did. You won. And all you had to do was complain. It's the secret to life, kids. So let's take these and make them a little bit less. 0 to 40. Man, I've gone and pretty much just redone everything here now. Well, you learned your lesson, right? The first time you make this whole procedural audio thing, you don't know how to do it. But then you dial it in, you get it a little better here and there. Complaining always works. Squeaky wheel gets the grease, right? Okay, after this, I'm done with this part. I'm just gonna go and do the drum note. All right, build that. Build. Okay, now we're gonna select a drum note. This is area create. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. It's a good one. I like fortune favors the bold. That's a good one too, right? Sometimes you gotta be bold to be complaining. Right? It depends on the complaint though. Sometimes there's annoying complaints where you're like, dude, it's so annoying, quit it. And it's like, you don't wanna help the person that's complaining like that. But if it's like an honest little complaint that makes sense, it's like, how can you not comply? Okay, so we got the music key, we got possible notes. Before we do all of this, I want to pick a drum note. Thinking, okay, so that some musical keys have two different notes to choose from in the whole department there of I think I'm just gonna loop through the key. Yeah, I think this will work. Okay, so we'll start with we'll go note type drum note equals K. No, I'll just go K note B four nothing. Drum note is less than or equal to K note C sharp. Drum note equals note type drum note plus one. And then if we don't have in our possible notes, if we don't have drum note, break. No, that doesn't work. That won't work. All right, we want it to go from loop. We can still loop over those notes, but we want to go the first one that does contain, we break. Yeah, okay. So if it contains, then we break. So we got, yeah, it starts at B, goes up to C sharp. If it's a possible note, it breaks. Should work. All right. So we can set that. Drum note is drum note. And we'll set a breakpoint here to make sure this does work. And I think this is gonna be about it for today's stream after I check this and run this and stuff. It's Saturday, man, I'm lazy. wish I could. I wish I was smoking weed right now, man. This would be the perfect day to smoke some weed. Alright, here we go. So we got possible notes. What are they? Seven notes. A sharp, C, D, D sharp, F, G, A. So this is a good key to start with because we're going to have to skip B. So yeah, it should find C. Weedy poo. Yes, oh, I wish. I wish. Oh, chocolate beer. I got this. I waited, what, something like 11 months? I ordered this vaporizer from like a Kickstarter. Right, it's this amazing vaporizer, by the way. And I ordered it in December of last year, and I waited all the way till the beginning of October, like 11 months or something like that, or 10 months. I waited for this vaporizer, and then right then was when I have to stop smoking weed. Like, I have to stop right now. My girl and I, we're trying to have a baby. Can't just be smoking weed right now. So ironic. It's like the most ironic thing ever. You wait that many months for something. You're like, I can't wait. Is it going to be this month? It's going to be this month? It's kind of funny if you think about it, though. One day I'll tell stories about this. All right, so we should find note C here. Start with B. Drum note should be B. If contains possible notes, drum note, break. But that shouldn't happen on the first one. But here on C, it should. Yes. And our drum note should be C. Good. Very, very good. Okay. And what's cool about how that loops is it actually starts with the first notes in the key. So it favors... It would favor C sharp, for example, in the key of C sharp. Yeah, I really like how that works. Instead of being random, it's based on the first... It would be a nice story you could tell your kid. Yes. Yes. All right, let's see this run. Okay, cool. Yeah, so drum note is 3C. So this should sound... Oh, this should sound exactly like the other key. Let's do a different key this time. I'm gonna force, let's do the musical key of K. Let's do A. See what A sounds like. Basically the drum, the kick noises, the snare noises, and the hat noises should sound a tiny bit different for each one of these keys. Trying to listen to see if I can hear that subtle difference. Obviously, you can hear the bass notes sound different. Drum note here is going to be B. It is a tiny bit lower. All right, cool. It works. Let's hear A sharp. So C sharp should select C sharp as the drum key or drum note. Let's try C sharp next. So A sharp chose C as the drum note. Boring, we already heard C. Let's do C sharp. Ah, cool. Well, this is the last little touches that I wanted to put on this song for now. Like I mentioned at the beginning of the stream, I'm kind of waiting on Fmod to improve their software just slightly. Sometimes when I go into a different room, you can hear it play half of a kick noise, which is really kind of annoying. And and I hope that Fmod fixes that. They should just add this one little feature, and it would make it so much easier to get rid of that problem. Oh, the drum note is C. No, wait, that's curious. I want to set a breakpoint and figure that out. Why is that? You're not hearing a big difference? It's not a big difference. It's a subtle difference. It's really hard to tell the difference between a C snare and a B snare. They're so close. The pad? Maybe it's not. Do you mean I'll solo it in the thing and we'll dial it in. You're probably right, because it's not playing the entire pad noise anyways. There's probably something wrong with it. Okay, this should be a C sharp, I think. It's the music key C sharp. Our possible notes should start with C sharp. Oh, it's contains. Oh, okay. I need to write this a little smarter. How would I get it so it would favor C sharp in the key of C sharp? No, wait, no, it's contains. It should work on the first try. No, wait. It starts with drum note. Oh. Oh, okay, I know how to do it. I want to start with, okay, so I want to have some, I need a vector of possible drum notes. So vector note type, possible drum notes. So we got K note B, K note C, and K note C sharp. And then we loop over the possible notes. And we start with drum note B or whatever. And we loop over the possible notes. And if contains possible drum notes note, then drum note equals note and break. There, so now it'll favor C sharp in the key of C sharp, or at least it should. All right, possible notes starts with C sharp. Possible drum notes, doesn't matter their order, for each possible note, we start with note C sharp. If contains possible drum notes, note. Yes, drum note equals note, break. Cool, it worked. There, that's a smarter way to do it. What's up, Disco? What's up, man? The game is coming along really well. It's very fulfilling to work on your own video game, to have it becoming so mature, just getting lots of great feedback on it, and playing it myself. I really enjoy playing it. It's like, it's going really, really well. I couldn't imagine going any better. There's that weird silence. Mr. Francie, let me know. Tell me where you're hearing that key problem. I guess there's a delay between what you're saying. hear it though. I think it's in key, from what I'm hearing. It's only using two notes for it. There's only truly two notes in this melody. There's D sharp and C sharp. It's as you said before. So it sounds out of tune to you. The pad, the little chirpy thing. Oh yeah, you're right. I think you're right because I did export these chirpy sounds. You're talking about this, right? Wait, I gotta set the index up. This one? This is what you're talking about as the pad? Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about now. I'm pretty sure this is it. And you're right. This is not in key because it has a random. Yeah, so check it out. When I wrote that part in Ableton, I think I can open this without crashing in the stream. Uh-huh. When I soloed that, was it the thing? I think it was. Basically, that little chirpy sound has a random effect applied to it, a random roll. So I guess I could... I think what I'll have to do is apply the scale to it, so it always chooses. So basically, this is how this track looks, right? I have a script which I wrote, which goes and exports tons of individual tracks for each note. I'll basically have to go into each one of these notes for the chirpy thing, and then make sure it's using the right scale, bass, and then it'll be in key. So it'll still sound random. It'll be like, it's got all these different random notes it chooses from. But they should be in key. You're right. I think right now it's doing random choices, four choices, three possible scale differences. I have no idea what notes it's actually choosing there. So I really do need to apply this scale back onto it to get it sounded just right. So thank you, man. Thank you for pointing that out. I forgot about that. It's not the chirpy? The bass is not in key with the pad? Which one is the pad? Here's the bass. That's the bass. There's the bass one, though. Oh, it's in the game only? Oh, this one right here? The bass one? Oh, the bass one is the thing that's not looping correctly, too. Did somehow this thing get? Oh, I see why you're calling that a pad. Yeah, totally. That one sounds like a pad. But it was actually just a copy of the bass that I made a little higher. Is it this one, though? It's not this one. What's this one, anyways? I think this only kicks in. Yeah, this one's like bleep, 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 bleep. So that sounds out of tune to you, huh? It has to be index one. Yeah, bass two is okay, so it's bass one. I wonder if this got messed up somehow. As a result, everything sounds the same. Let's see what note it's actually playing in the game for that. Think it's C. Yeah, no, don't be sorry for that, man. Thank you. It's really hard to notice all these little details, right? So you shouldn't be hearing that sound at all right now. And if you do hear that sound right now, definitely let me know, because then we get on the same page. But I'm pretty sure you'll hear it the second I go into this next room. Still too. Oh, right there, it did sound weird. Yeah, there's definitely some weird issues going on here with that silence and the I think it's the timing. I don't know. I think I'm gonna have to take a little detailed look at it later. I think it's playing C sharp 3.9. For this pad noise. Bass one. Wait, it's not. It's bass two or bass one. Wait, bass two should be the thing that's playing the pad noise. Yeah, the wob wob. It's really curious. I'm gonna have to go take a look at it. Oh, it's bass one. Okay, I'll look at bass one then. All right, cool. Well, thank you for your feedback, man. I really appreciate that. I am gonna have to take a break now because I've got my ears need a break. My legs need a break especially. But yeah, when I come back to this, I'll pay really close attention to what's going on here and try and figure out what is exactly going on here, especially with the timing. I think the timing is really, really messing with it, and somehow it's playing some silence there, and that is causing everything to just kind of sound out of order with it all. So I'll first fix the timing and then focus really hard on the tune of these basses and pad noises and stuff. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. Thanks a lot for watching, everybody. This is like day 4 or 5 or something like that of making procedural audio. This is gonna be up on Steam tonight. Hopefully, yeah, I'll get this out tonight. So this is just the first track, the first dungeon. Eventually, there'll be like 10 more procedural audio tracks or so that'll go into this game. So this first week has been pretty experimental and stuff like that. So as it gets progressive, it'll get or as it progresses, it'll get a lot more easier to do. Each track will get easier to do. So later, everybody. See ya. Thanks for watching again.